So I'm gonna read because I'm super nervous. So I wrote it. So hi, I'm LT, aka Linda Tronzo, gay. Say that word, gay. I want to thank Renee and Courtney for inviting me, because this is a great space, and for curating the show, and to acknowledge the last 2 years that have been so rough on the impact that has been so rough on us. So I've been working on portraits. A likeness is a way of talking of a presence. I was trying to queer myself into the portraits of famous dead male artists. When SIP happened, I was no longer able to go to museums or gallery shows. I began researching my own art books. I was interested in self-portraits, mostly 18th and 19th century. Rembrandt did over 100 self-portraits. I used gesture and color and their eyes to guide my paintings. I looked at Monet, Manet, de Curcio. I did copies of them all, and also then did one of myself to kind of match it. And I didn't find very many women when I was looking in that period of self-portraits. They weren't there. So almost, and that's what I have to say about the actual self-portrait. But I want to go into almost to this day, 1 year ago, I had a very close friend drop dead out of nowhere. And then my brother died unexpectedly, and then my mother-in-law, and then a professor I had in grad school. I went to grad school in 2006, and she's younger than me, and she also died. And so it's been some really hard times, and then May 25th happened. George Floyd got killed, and Breonna Taylor, Tony McDade, Jacob Blake, Ahmaud Arbery, and all these black women also, Michaela Bryant, Pamela Turner, 28 years old, Altrina Jefferson, 44, Sandra Bland, Yvette Smith, 47, Miriam Curry, 34, Shelley Frey, 27, Rika Boyd, 22, Katherine Johnson, 92, killed by the police. So there's so many reasons to scream. And so that's why I did a big scream, because it was such a big time of screaming for all of us. And of course, politics, collisions of all kinds, occurred, some in space, planets, once-in-a-lifetime events happened. I don't know if I missed anything, but I was thinking that maybe we could go around and we can each say what caused us to scream in the last, or we could have one big scream also, or maybe both. So if people would like to say, would you like to go around?
I will start because we lost the same dear friend, and it just seems like it's been a year of loss and death and so many close people. So I totally relate to this and feel this. Thank you.
I could scream just hearing the names of all the black women that you read, being ignorant of knowing that had happened. Knowing it had happened. Hearing the names, like you said, is like a presence, and a presence not felt but lost. Before you know.
Anybody else?
I could scream at all the human suffering and vulnerability that we are constantly just surrounded by, and it seems it's not going to end. It's just going to continue to get bigger and worse.
I was going to say, for me, the pandemic, luckily nobody close died and things fell away from the calendar, and it's actually a time of focusing, and it was okay. But
praying.
I lose my self-control about it.
Yes. And all those people that died, I just want to say none of them were COVID. Just put that out there.
I too lost several friends. One, I was with her when she passed, and I've never experienced anything like that. But yeah, two or three friends that were very, you know, one friend was only like 41. Tweet. And it was quite intense. None of them were COVID either. So, but my father-in-law had COVID. It's too many. Yeah. Sorry for your loss.
I feel like this country breaks my heart, and I feel like when George Floyd was murdered, I wasn't born and raised here, but it reminded me of what I learned in Ireland as a kid about Emmett Till being murdered. And when I feel heartbroken because I feel angry, and I recognize that in your painting, it's so powerful. When I see what's happening post-pandemic, when there was such potential and everyone said, oh, the world will change, and this country said it would change, and yet attacks and erosions on women's reproductive choice and health, and attacks on trans, bi's, and GLBT people in general, and back to the same institutionalized racism, it makes me feel like the country I moved to is the country I was trying to escape. Mm-hmm. And the country I was escaping is becoming the country I was moving to. And I feel that in your painting, it's a really powerful painting.
Thank you
for doing it.
Thank you. Anybody else, or should we just scream?
saw COVID, or see it still, as kind of an opportunity for us to become aware of all the injustices and all the dysfunction that's going on, and that it was an opportunity for us to kind of like sit back and be with ourselves and be with the world in a way that we never have before. And so screaming, it would be, for me, the fact that, yes, we're returning now, as you just said, to, you know, to somewhat like, you know, we're going through, we're transiting through this period and hoping that, you know, that we can make some changes, but there's still so many things that are falling apart and that haven't been resolved, and maybe we're overwhelmed about how to resolve them. So that's where I would scream. But I would also want to say that crisis equals opportunity.
Mm-hmm.
And that, you know, and anger is a good thing to have because it generates the fire to move us forward into a new direction. And I think that we need that.
Well, I agree.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. All right. Any,
ready to scream? My screaming would have to do with working in the public during COVID and all the people who had to experience that.
Yeah.
But what was coming in my mind when you're talking about screaming, the idea of the Tonglen meditation where you breathe all everybody's suffering in, and the screaming is the release where you offer your healing and your love to everyone. That's what I imagine of your screaming. I feel the pain, but I also see you giving what you can to others to heal.
This is a it's an interesting topic to me personally. I remember screaming exactly one time in the last 15 years, and it was late 2020 when I realized I live in an apartment by myself down the street. In the middle of San Francisco, maybe like right in the middle. And I realized that if I screamed, no one would care. And I think it's really almost ironic that I'm saying this out loud in front of a bunch of people listening to me. I guess we were all kind of doing the same thing.
Yeah.
And I don't know, just the idea that we scream to be heard, and sometimes that just doesn't happen. That's what I'm getting at.
LT, this is a beautiful piece. It's so, I've always loved your paintings, different things about the other things that you make with your hands, but this is something quite extraordinary for me. And I also appreciate what you said and about where it comes from for you. I appreciate that that is in you, because there's not a day that goes by that I don't feel like screaming, and sometimes I actually do when she's not here and in the house, and you know, I'll be in, look in the mirror and do it. Recently, the things that have made me want to scream are these recent confirmation hearings, and I'm so glad they were televised, and I'm so glad that I had the opportunity to watch them, because there was just this portrait of what Black women go through every day, every hour of the day. Mm-hmm. And, you know, people generally who are white or who are not Black or who are not brown and female don't really believe you. They don't understand that this is really what happens and what it must feel like. And to, it made me feel so many things to see the judge, her face while all of these questions were being asked, these horrible, disgusting insinuations and assaults. They were assaults, and the breaking of the raise of her eyebrow, that every Black woman knows what that means. We saw it in our mother's faces from the times we were little, and the level of composure that was required of her to endure these assaults is what is required of all of us every day, but this was an extraordinary display of it. And it made me, it also, I'm glad that people who are not Black got to see that and to feel the shame that should be felt in the presence of that, those kind of statements. But it also makes me want to scream when people then kind of look at me and say, well, you know, what do you feel? In many ways, it's a fine question, especially people know me. But it also, I want to tell, I'm so glad you said what you felt mm-hmm. about it. So I'm going to stop talking, but I just wanted to say, you know, how beautiful and the energy from this is extraordinary. So.
Stage to the next, there needed to be a breakdown of some sort. And the breakdown is the internal battle between what I feel is, you know, what I've learned to believe and what I've been cultivated through, you know, my childhood experiences or my social norms, and what deep down I feel is right. What I see here is kind of like the, you know, that breakdown process, but also the start of something new. And as you mentioned, like the names of some of these people, you know, these were deaths, but they were also, they also sparked growth. Conversation moved forward. So I see all of that here too.
I appreciate the how you've presented this idea about screaming, but what I see is also feeling protest. Mm-hmm. It's not just, I think that we all have our screaming moments, but this is more like a sounding an alarm to me. And that there should be response to it.
Mm-hmm.
And that we're not all really sitting alone, and that this is a time to figure out how to reach out and coalesce, and that it's not really limited to country borders, that our nation states, there seems to be, we're in a battle right now, and I kind of took the period of the pandemic, which I don't really think is over, to regroup myself and maybe take time off from having to listen to every podcast and respond to and show up for protests when I felt I can, and that there's really no vacation for this.
Mm-hmm.
So, it's a good reminder.
Forgive me, I'm not an artist, and forgive me, this is a very basic question. I'm just curious, as I'm looking at that, and I felt the activism or whatever, just by this one line with over her shoulder, that it goes up as if she was raising her hand or whatever. You're raising your hand? What is the... Is there a reason for the white, that background there, in that spot, or?
You know what, it's really about the process more, because I actually build the canvases from scratch, and it's handmade gesso, and I used to do clay work, I used to do ceramics, and I'm really like the process of making it and gessoing it and mixing the gessos and doing all this. I can't like disown it, and it has to speak as a. It's part of its own kind of voice in a way. Is to be that piece that it's hard to say it, but.
I just wanted to make a comment that I think is something very powerful to see a close-up of a face that screams, you know, and almost like a selfie, right? I just want to use that word on purpose,
right.
Because we are so surrounded and flooded, you know, with images of yourself in a completely different postures, and, you know, look at me, completely different. But here there is a sense of responsibility that you call the other person, you know, that is looking at that face, that screaming anger, and I think it's a very powerful gesture to, you know, immortalize that moment and actually magnify, you know, you know, that calls for, you know, definitely not for indifference, but a really powerful response from whoever is viewing it. And there's also something in your eyes there that I wanted to mention, because when we focus on the scream, we focus so much on the mouth, that it's open and it's kind of shouting and gesture and screaming, but there is something in your eyes there where unfortunately I don't see much hope. And that's, you know, there's a gaze there that is letting out of this internal breaking, as was mentioned, but there is something there that, you know, is like unfortunately a screaming and maybe may repeat again, you know, because I don't see, there's something in the gaze too that is screaming. Thank you for everything you said.
I just wanted to thank you for this presentation.
Oh, thank you.
It's a really wonderful way to open it up to the community as well.
Yeah, it's such a community show, and Renee has opened it up to the community. So
it's really
and
nice.
Courtney.
A gift to hear you talk about your work.
Oh, thank you. So, anybody want to scream?
Thank you,
everybody.
Thank you.